Well, the leather jacket has left the closet. It was $9,000, by the way. And the smell of freshly baked GPUs are now wafting through the digital kitchen. So you know what time it is? It's new NVIDIA GPU time. Now, a lot of coverage is out there already, but we wanted to be the tortoise here and we wanted to be thorough with our coverage and give you a full guide of what came out of last night's announcement. Because believe it or not, what you saw on stage versus what has actually come out from NVIDIA and everything else is very, very large. And we're gonna talk about that right here, right now on Robeytech. So this is gonna be a different video than what you've typically seen. Obviously, we're in a different location. We're here on location here at CES. The reason we're doing this is because the RTX 50 series, codenamed Blackwell, has officially been announced. And there's a lot to unpack, but there is just as much that we have yet to fully discover because honestly, the amount of information that we got was kind of just a trickle. Now, the good news is that we won't have long to wait because both the RTX 5080 and the RTX 5090 will be launching on January 30th, with the RTX 5070 and the 5070 Ti launching sometime in February. Now, there was also mention of an RTX 50 series laptops, that those are gonna be coming available as soon as March, but I've heard the rumors here at CES that there are some manufacturers trying to make that even earlier. There's no word on the RTX 5060 and 5060 Ti desktop GPUs yet, but with NVIDIA's release schedule, basically of the past, that isn't all that surprising. So as a side note, and just so you know we're not being reductive, NVIDIA CEO Jensen basically talked about a whole lot more than just GPUs. In fact, it was a whole lot more than just GPUs, like an hour plus more than just GPUs. It was basically fascinating things about, you know, architecture and driving technology progress. And if it's the kind of thing that really interests you, you should actually watch the keynote and you can actually check it out for yourself right here when we did it live. As for us, we're gonna talk about the RTX 50 series starting with pricing, and boy, was everybody wrong on these. So NVIDIA shocked us out of the gate with the launch price of the RTX 5070 at around $550. Now, for context, that is $50 lower than the launch price of both the RTX 4070 and the 4070 Super. Not only that, Jensen made a pretty bold claim that the GPU is going to have RTX 4090 levels of gaming performance, which maybe more AI speak, but getting our hands on will tell us all if that was actually gonna be true. But that's what he said. Now, following that same price trend, the 5070 Ti has a launch price of $750, which is also $50 less than the 4070 Ti and the 4070 Ti Super. Now, the 5080 matched the 4080 Super's launch price at $1,000, which is pretty surprising considering the rumors that this thing was supposed to be priced way higher. We're talking like $1,500 or $1,600. Now, as for the RTX 5090, this GPU will have a $2,000 price tag. Now, there are some significant leaps in specs from the 4090 for the 5090 here, but we'll talk about that when we share our thoughts on pricing in just a minute. So what does this new generation of GPUs mean for gamers? Now, while NVIDIA said that we could see up to 2 times the performance of their previous generation counterparts, we'll basically have to wait and see till we have those GPUs in our hand to see if this actually pans out. However, there is some new tech that's driving these new claims, starting with the leap from GDDR6X to GDDR7. With that, there's also an increased memory bandwidth that's either on parity with the amount of VRAM each GPU has, or in the case of the RTX 5090, actually more. If the 24 gigabytes of VRAM on the RTX 4090 wasn't enough, the 5090 has 32 gigs of VRAM. Now, there's also a pretty seismic shift here in how NVIDIA is leveraging neural networks. I know, hang in there, there's some AI speak here, but it's cool. Now, around 6 years ago, with early DLSS, NVIDIA trained AI models to render frames at lower resolutions and upscale them. Now, this technology has evolved over time, and now, rather than that process of training and implementation being separate, NVIDIA is integrating these neural networks inside of programmable shaders to create what they're calling a neural shader. See, this enables better compression, higher quality textures, and more thorough local learning. So NVIDIA also talked about updating DLSS with a whole new vision transformer model to improve features like ray reconstruction, deep learning anti-aliasing, and super resolution. See, this model helps reduce image ghosting, produces smoother edges, and helps maintain higher detail in motion. All things that have been pointed out as issues with DLSS in the past. And this update isn't just for 50 series GPUs either. This new transformer model will be available on other RTX GPUs using these technologies. And 40 series will see enhancements to DLSS frame generation itself that will increase performance while lowering memory usage, which is awesome. Now, we'll have to see just how well it works when we actually see those updates out and we test them before our full review. Now, NVIDIA did hold one feature back for the RTX 50 series. It's DLSS4 multi-frame generation, and this is exclusive to 50 series guys. Rather than just sandwiching frames in between frames like they did in DLSS frame generation, multi-frame generation, which I think you've probably gathered by now, basically generates up to 3 extra frames per one rendered, which is a lot of extra frames. In some of the tech demos, users could control the number of extra frames generated with 2x, which is matching frame generation of the 40 series, while 3 and 4 went beyond what the 40 series was capable of doing. Now, if you want a deep dive on this, you should check out the Digital Foundry video, which is you could watch actually right here. Basically, they did a whole thing on DLSS4 and the RTX 5080, which is hard to capture all of the improvements in a single YouTube video. They did a really good job highlighting the features and visual improvements. Now, if you're worried about input lag from adding even more frames, Digital Foundry also showed that increased latency from standard frame generation to multi-frame generation is essentially negligible. It's like around 6 milliseconds going from 2 to basically 4x multi-frame. NVIDIA also teased Reflex 2 in both their website and in some of their press materials as a solution to reduce input latency alongside the soon-to-be-released frame warp feature, which also reduced mouse latency even further. Essentially, gamers using RTX 50 series GPUs are just gonna have to admit that it was their skill issues that forced them to miss their shots. And one other big thing or small thing worth mentioning is that all of those memes about growing GPU sizes, the Founders Edition RTX 5090 that Jensen actually showed off was small and it only had 2 fans. In fact, NVIDIA lists it as a 2-slot GPU, which means that it meets NVIDIA's SFF ready standard that it actually launched last year. And Jensen did actually show us the PCB and it was tiny, but that didn't really seem to make board partners make smaller cards because some of those cards are ginormous. Okay, so we've shared some specs and a bit about the tech. So what do we think? Let me just preface what I'm about to share with this. Charts and videos during presentations like this are dazzling, but we won't know just how well these GPUs perform until we run them through our batteries of tests along with people like Linus and Jay and everybody else. That being said, if NVIDIA's performance claims hold true and the prices stay around MSRP, we may be in for something special with the RTX 50 series cards. Now for starters, the $550 price tag for the RTX 5070 is a solid move. Now while this is still an investment for a GPU, if it performs twice as well as the RTX 4070 and 4070 Super and it costs less, well, that's a pretty sweet deal. Even sweeter if the performance actually takes the swing at the 4090 like Jensen claimed. Now for the 5070 Ti, it's an enthusiast card with an enthusiast price. Again, it's always nice to see their launch price lower than its predecessor, and we're not surprised to see how it's basically hovering around here. Now with the 5080, I'm actually not mad about the $1,000 price tag. It's an upgrade from the 4080 and the 4080 Super in technology, memory bandwidth, and features, and it performs better than both of them, so I'd call that a win. So now let's talk about the $2,000 price tag on the RTX 5090. Listen, I'm not gonna pretend that that's not a lot of money. Heck, we've built some killer PCs for around the same cost as one of these bad boys. But NVIDIA has done some things with this that helps that price make a little bit more sense, even if it doesn't make it cheaper. For starters, that 32 gigs of VRAM is going to be amazing for basically data scientists, coders, video editors, animators, and yes, even gamers too. Though I have to be honest, if a game's chewing through 32 gigs of VRAM, you might have some optimization issues with your favorite title. And it's not just about the extra helping of VRAM that this is all about either. It's the expanded bandwidth and memory interface width that is going to help GPU-dependent professionals save time on their tasks. And time is one resource that we could all stand to have a little bit more of. As for the feature set of the 50 series, guys, we're actually pretty excited to see the evolution for DLSS. It's come a long way since DLSS1, and it just keeps getting better and better if DLSS4 multi-frame generation and these new neural shaders give us a generational improvement with visuals, frame rates, and performance over what we're seeing in DLSS3 and beyond. Now, when we look at this new stack, if you're on a RTX 30 series or Radeon RX 6000 series, or hey, even a 1660 or below, this could be a great time to upgrade, especially if the performance leaps hold true. Just don't spend any money before we validate those performance claims. Guys, pre-orders, just wait. I know people are worried about scalpers, but if you can be patient, it may be worth it. Now, it's not all sunshines and puppies here because there is one thing that didn't quite make it into the keynote, and that's That's raw performance data. Now, all the metrics we saw were ray traced with DLSS and multi-frame generation active. Even in their charts that they showed, the fine print said that the numbers represented frame gen of the 40 series cards versus four-time multi-frame gen numbers of the 50 series. Now, we think this is where those bold claims about RTX 4090 levels of performance coming from a 5070 are actually holding true. So not exactly a one-to-one comparison here, but there is a story here that I don't think is getting talked about enough. Now, we're seeing more and more cinematic titles like Indiana Jones and the Great Circle, Alan Wake 2, Final Fantasy 16, and more that are absolutely stunning gaming experiences. And these are gonna be made possible by technologies like DLSS, frame generation, and ray reconstruction, in terms of graphics, by me. I think we're entering era in gaming where these technologies are mature and are becoming more and more integrated by game developers to achieve that visual spectacle that absolutely wows us. And whatever side of the fence you're on, you know what? Honestly, with Indiana Jones actually requiring you to have ray tracing, I'm sorry, but this just seems to be like the direction where things are going. So when we see charts that show low raw performance and then astronomical leaps with DLSS 3 and DLSS 4 enabled, it doesn't necessarily mean that the GPU is bad at its job, but that the technology that it's driving to assist its performance is that good. What we're seeing right now is the dazzle of marketing here. We just won't know for sure until we're able to validate what actual performance looks like with and without the uplift once we actually have our GPUs in hand. Please just don't burn any buildings down or sell your current GPU over marketing charts just yet. There was also another omission. We heard a lot about just how powerful these GPUs are, but we didn't hear about how power hungry they are. Now, after looking through all of the official information, we created a chart over at robeytech.com showing the total graphics power, or TGP, and the recommended size of power supply needed for the 50 series GPUs. Now, when we look at the numbers compared to the previous generation, we're seeing an increase of TGP from just over 5% all the way up to around 28%, depending on the GPU you're trying to choose. So basically, if you're considering a 50 series GPU, make sure your PSU can handle the needed juice and preferably that it can support a PCI 5 cable, or at least that it has enough 8-pin connectors to feed NVIDIA's adapter. You know what, I wonder if they're doing the old adapter. That thing was ugly. One final comment here about power and how small this GPU is. We're curious about how these things are gonna handle heat. It was interesting to see the new cooler design of the Founders Edition cards. I'm not gonna lie, it does look pretty slick with its two fans, stealth heat sink with a vapor chamber design. But looks aside, we're gonna have to see how practical the design is. Now, NVIDIA did state that this is a flow-through design, so this design could deal with any potential heat issues. We just know that the extra power draw is going to generate extra heat, and that heat has to go somewhere. Hopefully that somewhere is away from the GPU. Well, guys, we're gonna wrap this one up, and I hope that you guys noticed that all the time and attention we took to give you all of the information was worth the wait that it took for this video to come out. And I'd love to know if that was helpful down in the comments below and if you actually learned anything. Also, let me know, what did you think about 50 series? Where do you sit on the whole AI is necessary for gaming? I'd love to know that as well. While you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post videos like this and more coverage of 50 series that's absolutely coming up. Also, if you want to continue the conversation now, just want to hear your thoughts or find other people that want to talk about this stuff, head on over to Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech, amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to have these conversations. You know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us on all the other socials at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.